So one of the other tools that is absolutely awesome for this kind of thing and coming up with ideas, generating random patterns, is Max for Live. So are there any Max for Live users here? Anyone who doesn't know what Max for Live is? Totally fine. So everyone understands what Max for Live. Don't need me to explain what Max for Live is. Cool. So Max for Live has got a ton of devices available. There's audio effects, MIDI effects, instruments, but the MIDI effects in particular, there's quite a few of them, can be really interesting for helping you come up with ideas. So there's one in particular that I really love using, and it is called the MDD SnAkE device. So this is quite a cool device. It's actually modeled on a piece of Eurorack hardware by Make Noise, I think. I can't remember what the actual hardware is called. But so it's modeled on a piece of Eurorack hardware, but it generates note data. So we've got chords, we've got drums, let's go for a bass line. I'm gonna grab another sound. Let's drop that on there. Cool, let's just turn this off for now. So the way this device works, which is pretty fun, is I've got this random all button just over there behind me. The device feeds out notes, so pitch data, feeds out gates, which are on and off, so basically just like a note playing an actual note, velocity data, and then this custom data that we can map to something as well. And when I hit random all, it just completely randomizes all of that. So it's gonna be quite loud. Let's get myself a random pattern. Hit it again, another random pattern. What I want to do though, again, this is just kind of not in any particular key. So I'm going to grab my scale device, my C minor, just to make sure everything's working in my same key. And it's also got those sort of screechingly high notes, which we want a bit of a bass line. So what we can do is just restrict the range of the randomization. And again, this is something that you'll want to pay attention to a lot when using randomization, is having some control over it. So we don't just want a complete random range of notes in any key. We want to kind of choose our key and select only the lower notes here. Pretty cool bass line. And it just hits random, just generate a bunch of bass lines. It's kind of a cool one, I'll go with that one. So the sequencer generates those notes in real time. So if I were to turn this off, I get no notes. So you can use the same routing if you wanted to record those MIDI notes. I could set up another MIDI track and just tell it to either receive MIDI from that bass track, or I could route that track to send its MIDI, and I can record what's coming out of that bass track. So I've got that there. I can turn that off. Got my bass line. But we're going to leave it, we'll leave it to run. I'll keep that MIDI clip over there, but we're going to leave it to run in real time because I want to use this for something else as well. So the bass line is going to run in real time. So far we've just been generating notes, but one of the things that we can use randomization for in an interesting way is to change the character of the sound itself as well. Because at the moment we've got this pattern of notes, but the sound's pretty constant. So maybe we want to have a slightly evolving sound as well. So for example, in the SnAkE device, we've got this custom sequence. So I'm sure if you've used Max for Live before, you might have come across devices like this. Max for Live has a bunch of different devices that let you map to controls in Ableton Live. So what I can do is I can hit this map button and click on a control, and you'll see that's kind of grayed out because it's now under the control of this device. And when I hit play, what you'll see is going to happen. Notice how that control is being sequenced by this sequence here. Got this slightly evolving pattern, which is pretty cool. Let's bring these drums back in. Again, going back to Max for Live. One problem I have a lot with drum tracks in particular, programmed drum tracks, is they can get very stale very quickly. They can get very repetitive and often get stuck trying to come up with longer patterns, patterns that have kind of changing feels to them. So there's some cool ways that you can deal with this with, again, with MIDI effects, with Max for Live. So one simple way is using Live's velocity MIDI effect. So I'm one of those really nerdy people that gets excited whenever I see just the word random, because I know I can do some cool stuff with it. So the velocity MIDI effect has got this random control in it. And what that does is, I'll just crank it full so you can hear. Make sure I've got, it randomizes the velocity of the notes that get sent to it. So these are all same velocity that you hear they're being randomized. Which it's quite extreme at this point, but kind of creates that interesting sort of push-pull feel of the groove, which is pretty cool. So this is something I use all the time for, particularly for drum grooves, to bring a little bit of life to them. It's another area where you can use some randomness. Another really cool set of Max for Live devices is a set of Max for Live devices called Chance 10. So these are 10 devices that use chance and randomness to process MIDI data. So you can just Google these and you'll find them online. This first one is called Play. The way this works is you set a percentage chance that any note that goes through that device is going to be triggered. So at 100%, every note gets triggered. We get our full beats. Anything less than that, so let's go 50%. 50% of our notes, okay, we'll go 51, aren't going to be triggered. So you can hear that. So immediately we've got this sort of non-repetitive, the feel is still there, but it's kind of changing every time, as if it was maybe like a real drummer playing it, which is pretty cool. And again, we can capture all of this randomness. Again, sticking with our theme of Max for Live, there's plenty of stuff to be found with Max for Live. There's a couple other control devices that we can use to randomize things. So you have this device called the LFO. Anyone who's worked in the world of sort of modular synthesis, you'll be familiar with using LFOs and modulators to create these changing patterns and unsynced patterns and polyrhythms and things with randomness. It's very common in the modular space. So with Max for Live, you can kind of bring that idea into Live as well. So what this allows you to do is to modulate parameters. So for example, we can do something similar that we did earlier. If you remember, we had our hi-hat. I can take this LFO and I can map it to a control. See how that's being modulated, but I can change this to a random pattern, and maybe let's have it. But what's quite cool about the LFO is you can actually have multiple things being modulated by a single LFO. Maybe let's restrict the range a little bit. Turn this play off. It's making that beat just a little bit more interesting.